Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. And for this video you will learn how to create After Effects animations. So if you want to be a motion designer and if you want to earn some money by becoming a motion designer, then this is a basic level video for you in which you will learn how to create typing animation in After Effects. You will learn how to create tracking, you will learn how to create scrolling, you will learn how to create typewriter and bouncing type animation in After Effects. If you want to learn, don't forget to subscribe the channel and comment on the video below to let us know what more you would like to learn in After Effects. So adding over to my teammate who will teach you all of that. So without further ado, let's get into the screen.
Hello everyone, welcome back to another tutorial of After Effects. And in this video, as you can see in the title, we will be learning about typing animations in After Effects, like bouncing, scrolling, and typewriter, and so on. So without further ado, let's jump right in. First thing is tracking. So let's start our new composition. I'll name it as tracking, and my frame is 1920 by 1080. Frame rate I will write 30, and duration is 3 seconds. Okay, now we will be selecting type tool for our typing animation. You can also press Ctrl T, and I will type tracking, and I will select the selection tool again and then align it to the center. We have this tracking layer here, so I'm gonna click on this drop down and then click on this animate option and tracking, and this range selector one will appear here, and you are going to use the tracking amount for your animation. I'm gonna click on this stopwatch, place this keyframe at 0 seconds, drag it to 1 second, and I will place or type 100 here, and let's play it. See, this is how it will look like. Basically it will increase the amount of spacing in this. That's what a tracking is. And to make it more smoother, I'm gonna place another keyframe at 1.10 seconds, and I'm gonna type 0. For another smoothness, I'm gonna place 10 here, another 0. Or you can just click on this and copy, Ctrl C and Ctrl V to paste it. Now let's play it. You can see it is quite smooth now, and for more smoothness you can select all of them, right click on this keyframe, keyframe assistant, easy ease, or you can press F9 for more smoothness. Another thing we can do is make sure you have selected all these keyframes, and you have to click on this graph editor, and you can define the speed of this animation. I'm gonna click on this and it will reveal its options. I'm gonna drag it to right and drag it to left, play it. You can see the speed has increased. For this one, I'm gonna make it a more curvy. It's good now. And another thing you can add is motion blur in it. So I'm gonna click on the motion blur option, then click on this checkbox. Let's play this. You can see there is a bit blurriness when it is moving. That's all we had for this tracking animation. Let's go for the next one. The next animation is called scrolling. So let's start creating it. I'm gonna select the type tool again, type scrolling, select selection tool, make sure to align it to the center. Now what I'm gonna do is I will make a path and make this text scroll on that particular path. Make sure to select this layer, scrolling text layer, click on this pen tool, draw a path, whatever you like. You can adjust that path as well, selection tool, and then drag it. The path we have created is now on this layer. Click on this and you can see the mask and text here. I'm gonna click on this text option and then go for the path options. In the path you see there is none selected here. We are going to select mask one. The text is now on this path because we have selected the mask one here. And now for the animation, I'm gonna go for the first margin, click on this stopwatch, place keyframe here, define starting position from the left, scroll it back. Let's place the second point at 2 seconds, type 0 here, and then scroll it to right, and let's see what's the result. That's good. You can also adjust with the speed graph. If you want the speed fast from the start and slow at the end, you can adjust that in here. And for the other options, we also have reverse path. If I will show you, see, if I will click on this off button, you can see the text is now reversed. And for the perpendicular to the path, each and every letter appear now is perpendicular to the path. And for the force alignment, so it will basically align the text to your path like this. So you can play around with these options if you want. So that's all for this scrolling animation. Let's go for the next one. So the third animation is called typewriter. Basically, each and every letter will appear one by one like we have in typewriter. So let's select the type tool again. I'm going to write type right here, selection tool, and align it to the center. For this animation, we are going to do the same process, text, and go to animate, then opacity. After that, rain selector one will appear here. I'm going to make this opacity 0. Then we don't need to click on this stopwatch icon. We don't need to create any keyframe here. For the keyframe, let's go for this rain selector one. Click on drop down. You see this start option. I'm going to click on this stopwatch icon, and the opacity I want at the start is 0, and for 1 second the opacity should be 100. And you can see each and every letter is appearing one by one like this. It's a bit fast, so I'm going to move it to 2 seconds, and let's see. Okay, so this is how we create the typewriter effect animation. To make it more realistic, you can also do one thing. You can place a cursor that will appear one by one after each letter like this. So for that, I'm going to create another layer, another text layer. So for that, click on this type tool. I'm going to type a cursor and then click on selection tool to deselect the typing tool. Make sure to align it with this text, and after that we need to create animation in this cursor. I'm gonna click on this layer and enable opacity. I'm pressing T for opacity and Shift P for position at the same time. Also, I have to do one more thing here. For this typewrite word, I'm gonna click on character and increase the spacing amount in this word like this. Also align this cursor and position it according to the text. Yeah, like this. And let's click on these stopwatches, and I'm gonna make this opacity 0 for now. The position is okay. I'm gonna make another keyframe here for 100, another for 0. You can also copy the first keyframe we put here. I'm gonna copy this opacity and paste it here again. The next keyframe I want is here, and I'm gonna click on this position and shift, and I want it here. So you can see it will be like this, and I'm gonna put all these keyframes, and I will set the position and opacity for all these. Let's see. So I have pasted all these keyframes for every word, and the final result will be like this. Also, you can do one thing. Press U and select these 2 points, apply keyframe assistant, or press F9, and then go to the graph editor and set the speed accordingly. And then it will be like this. So that's what we had for this typewriter animation. Let's go for the next one. So our last animation is called bounce. I have bounce here already and aligned it to the center. Then what you gotta do is click on this drop down, click on this animate button, and you see this position. Click on this. The position range selector one has been added here. We just need to define the position now. -200, enter, and then you don't need to define any keyframe for this. You just need to write this. And for the bounce effect, you need to click on this add button, click on this selector and expression. Then you need to just paste an expression here. Click on this drop down and click on this amount. Then you see this select value, click on this and just paste your expression for the bounce effect. You can find this expression in the description. Now if I will show you the result, you can see it's a bit bouncy. If you want to change this expression and your bounce effect, you can do that easily by clicking here. Let me show you. So we have these values for our bounce. Delay means it is the delay for each letter. And we have frequency of the bounce. We have amplitude and offset. So you can adjust that according to your likings. So let's add another effect in this bounce. Close this expression for now. I'm gonna click on this animate and click on this fill color and RGB. Then the color has been changed. Let's set it accordingly. I'm gonna make it purple. I'm gonna click on this stopwatch, and I want it to change the color when it completes one bounce. So I'm gonna make it blue. again, copy this keyframe, Control C and Control V to paste. Let's play this. Looks nice. So yeah, that's what we created in this animation. And that's a wrap. Now you know how to create some awesome typing animations. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. And if you enjoyed this video, you can like this and subscribe. If you have any confusion, you can ask in the comment section. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.